said to the SGO, they don't think the quality of the discussion here will be at the level. They need serious discussion. So these are the people who claim they have the values and the understanding of the ANC. But the branches that are the organization, they think, no, just riffraff. They want the discussion at a very high level.
The day we allow people to march to houses of our children, whilst they work in their own workplaces, that will be wrong. That is why when people were marching to the Kuptas, we hit you with stand grenades. Because we don't want you to do that. When people march to Solima Baila, we must hit them hard. And when they march to Peter Bruce, we must hit them hard. When you come to my house, I finish you.
This family is playing a very toxic role. But we can't only blame the Guptas, we must also blame their collaborators inside our movement and government as well. Because our concern is that we don't know with the ANC now whether we're in an alliance with the ANC or the Guptas, or whether we're in an alliance with a faction.
It's a fallacy for anybody to say that there is no white monopoly capitalism. It's basically denying our understanding and how we characterize South Africa as a colonialism of a special type.
9 out of those 11 commissions said the phenomenon of monopoly capital is a global one, and it manifests itself differently in various parts of the globe. And in that context, it would therefore not be correct to characterize ours simply as white monopoly capital.
It is technically correct in the context of the South African political economy to talk of white monopoly capital. With this understanding in mind, it is also important to lay the emphasis on the fact that it is monopoly capital as such that is the primary adversary of the collective interests of our people, regardless of its color.
We knew Vuani Malamlele a year ago that it will happen.
Even if 3 or 6 comrades contest for the presidency, number one becomes the president, number two in terms of numbers becomes the deputy.